गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, अस्सलामु अलैकुम, नमस्कार, आदाब। टुडे इज अ वेरी स्पेशल डे एंड वी ऑल आर गैदर्ड हियर टू सेलिब्रेट द वर्ल्ड एनवायरनमेंट डे दैट इज एवरी ईयर सेलिब्रेटेड ऑन 5th June। दिस डे इज वेरी स्पेशल फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस बिकॉज दिस डे बिलोंग्स टू एवरीवन। दिस डे बिलोंग्स टू ऑल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। This day belongs to all creatures on this earth. This day belongs to everything, everyone, whatever exists in this universe. So this day is so auspicious, so special, and this day is so important for each one of us. And today we all are gathered for the common concern, the concern of our environment, the concern of our environment being misused. Our environment that has become polluted, damaged because of our selfish motives. Because of our human beings' selfish motives, we think that this world belongs to us only. And we try to utilize maximum for our own selfish purposes. We don't realize that this belongs to the animals. This belongs to the forest, this belongs to the oceans, this belongs to the species in the oceans, this belongs to everything, whatever is in the nature. And that's why today, DPMI Darbhanga has taken this initiative on this special day to organize a special lecture, a special discussion where we all are going to discuss on biodiversity, and we are going to discuss about ecosystem restoration, as this year is announced by UNO as theme of this World Environment Day is ecosystem restoration. So what are the issues, how we are going to deal with, what is the responsibility of an adult, what are the responsibility of youth, and what is the responsibility of the government and the common people? And to discuss these burning issues, we have a very eminent person with us. We have a person who is the man of action and who has proved himself an environmentalist. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Commander Mr. Vijay Kumar. Commander Vijay Kumar ji, welcome to DPMI Darbhanga, and we all are honored with your benign presence. Let me have the honor of presenting a few lines about Commander Vijay Kumar ji. Although his profile is so long that it's going to take quite long time, but I am not going to go in the details, but I am going to announce whatever is important and whatever is the integral part of his personality. So I'll just take 1 minute time to share my screen, and Mr. Vijay Kumar and I both are in one team, and we both work with TTOT. TTOT is a group where we all assemble together. And we all learn that how we can train the people, not the people, but train the trainers. That is the functioning of TTOT, and there Mr. Vijay Kumar is always the most appreciated trainer. Isn't it, Mr. Vijay Kumar? Your sessions are always awesome.
All your blessings from our various participants.
So, ladies and gentlemen, here we have the profile of Commander Vijay Kumar ji. On joining the Indian Navy in 1975, Commander Vijay Kumar was trained in weather forecasting at India MET Department and in oceanography at IIT Delhi, and served under the Directorate of Naval Meteorology and Oceanography in the Indian Navy for 17 years out of the 23 years. He served in the Navy till 1998. He was also the command Environment Officer, Western Naval Command, Mumbai for 2 years in 1996 and 1998. He has participated in oceanographic research cruises with the Scientific of Naval Physical and Oceanographic Laboratory, Kochi, Naval Institute of Oceanography, Goa, and also in a Russian oceanographic research ship in the Indian Ocean. He was a member of the 10th Indian expedition to Antarctica of a total duration of 4 months in 1990. Post his retirement, he has spent 23 years in corporate training as head of training for 12 years in two IT companies and last 11 years as a faculty in 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, Corporate Training for Managers. He is also a co-author of a book, Rise and Shine, where he has tried to apply the principles of Patanjali Yoga Sutra to character building. His qualifications include MSc Maths, MSc Yogic Science, and 3 Management and Training Postgraduate Diplomas. Commander Vijay Kumar ji, it's really an honor and privilege, proud privilege for us to have you this morning at DPMI Darbhanga. DPMI Darbhanga is an institute that always motivates and inspires the children or the students to achieve the greater heights in their lives. And I am personally very much fascinated towards your expedition of Antarctica. And sometimes in my life, if I get the chance, I would love to listen from you. How was the journey? How was the journey of expedition to Antarctica? Thank you very much, Mr. Vijay ji. And now with these words, I would like to request Vijay Kumar ji to kindly say his golden words and advise us how to be successful in life and enlighten us on biodiversity. Over to you, Mr. Vijay Kumar ji.
Yeah, thank you so much for this honor. Let me share my screen. Let me, 1 minute. All of you able to hear me and see me also?
Yes.
Yeah, let me share my screen. The screen is also visible?
Yes.
Okay, the topic given to me, I think Halima ji has given me 30 minutes. So this will continue from 11:10 to 11:40. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. Biodiversity and why is biodiversity loss is a concern for us. I'll make it, keep it simple, keep it less complicated, not theoretical, but just based on my own experience of being an environmentalist of sorts for the last maybe 25 years. Now, Kaun Banega Crorepati ka ek quiz hai. Who is the most dangerous one for the environment and its occupants? When I say occupants, it just does not mean only the human beings. The human species, animal species, the birds, the trees, and the environment itself, that is air, water, earth, everything. So I will give you 4 choices, A, B, C, D, like Amitabh Bachchan gives. And the 4 choices are, 1, human being, 2, elephants, 3, tigers, 4, lions. And आपका समय स्टार्ट होता है शुरू होता है अब तो कौन बनेगा करोड़पति में मोस्ट डेंजरस कौन है चैट में लिखिए 1, 2, 3, 4 चैट लेट मी सी द चैट Okay, Halima ji, you can tell me. Yeah, people are writing in the chat. Oh, people are writing.
Yeah, they are writing human beings.
Sahi. Yeah, per time. So lock kiya jaye.
Yes.
So human ko lock kiya jaye. So human ko lock karne se pura dunya ka problem solve ho sakta hai. क्योंकि पूरा प्रॉब्लम का जड़ है ह्यूमन बीइंग. अनफॉर्चुनेटली द लायंस आर नॉट डेंजरस, एलिफेंट्स आर नॉट डेंजरस, टाइगर्स आर नॉट डेंजरस, दे हैव बीन लिविंग इन द अर्थ फॉर मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स. It's only the human being who has come last out of these. He is the one, he or she. Yeah? I mean, when I say he, it's just not me, only he. The person, that is a human being, the human species is the one which is creating all the problems. Now, why is it so? Human beings are not poisonous. Snakes are poisonous. Human beings don't have sharp teeth. Tigers and lions have sharp teeth. Elephants are more powerful than human being, but they should be the one who are actually creating problems for all of us. But no, all of you agree that it is human being, because human being can produce poison. I am in a place called Mangalore, and very close to this place, about 50-60 kilometers from here, the Kerala and Karnataka government had started the spray of endosulfan for their cashew nut plantations and paddy plantations. This was started about 25 years ago, and for 17 years continuously it was going on, and people were suffering the consequences of this poison. The governments thought that it is not required to stop it because the profitability of the plantations was considered as more important than the people. And what did it do to the people? Entire generation of people have been born in the district with genetic deformities. This is a family residing in that village. The entire 3 children are deformed at birth. And just last 5 years, they have stopped spraying after spraying for 25 years. But people are not able to eat anything there because the water has been polluted, the wells have been polluted, the earth has been polluted. It has become a place like living hell. So now I can understand why you people said that human being is the most dangerous species on earth as compared to any other things. Have anyone seen this house sparrow these days? Which was a regular thing when we were growing up. We had those clocks, pendulum clocks. The sparrow will make a small nest within that where the pendulum is there. It will make a nest in our switchboard, small gap it is there. Now there are no sparrows now. And what they are saying is that sparrows have disappeared because of the radiation from the telecom towers. Now, why sparrow is important? Who cares for sparrow? How does it matter if sparrow is not there? It matters because sparrows eat the worms as their food. And worms can be dangerous. And if sparrows are not there, we'll have to spray poison to destroy the dangerous worms. And when it is killing those worms, it also kills so many other useful worms, like the earthworms, which are good for the human being because they are the ones who make the land fertile. The sparrows will pick up only those worms and insects which are not harmful to human being. And that is how the nature has kept the balance. So sparrow nahi hai, spray karna padega. Spray karega, zameen kharab hoga, hawa kharab hogi. Pani kharab hoga, cancer aayega, all because we have killed the sparrow. Insects are there and they are there for a purpose. Too many insects can be dangerous. They will invade the entire area from, it started from Iran to Pakistan to Rajasthan to, it went up to Punjab last year because of the uncontrolled population. But when the they are in small number, they act as a food for the frogs. And frogs eat the insects. They eat the insects. They eat the mosquitoes, which give rise to diseases like dengue and malaria and chikungunya. The frogs are eaten by snakes. Frogs are not there, then snakes cannot survive, because snakes require frog as the food. And frogs are, snakes are eaten by peacocks. So nature has ensured that there is a good balance in all these species. Worms are there, eaten by frogs. Frogs are eaten by snakes, and snakes are eaten by peacocks. When worms reduce or insects reduce because of our spraying of poisonous chemicals, the insects disappear and frogs have to starve to death. And frogs disappear, the snakes have to starve to death. When snakes disappear, peacocks have no food. The peacocks, otherwise they are in the jungle. Now I am in a place which is not a jungle, and I see these frogs in front of my yard, just outside my, inside my gate. Am I happy to see the peacock inside my gate? The peacock's place is not within the human civilization. They're supposed to be in some forest areas. But they come here to enter my house. I'm not happy with it, because when they come in large numbers, they just invade the paddy field and destroy the entire paddy cultivation. Now, why did they come there? Because they are not getting the food where they are supposed to get. And what made them starve in their place? We have made them starve by breaking the food chain, starting from the worms and insects right up to the snakes. So we are responsible for peacocks to come to my backyard or front yard in this case. We see in Sanjay Gandhi National Park, in Mumbai, the leopards come into housing complexes and get inside the bedroom and kill people and carry dogs. Dog is not their natural prey, but they have no other option. We see elephants coming and invading the place where humans reside, all because we have invaded their residence. So biodiversity has been severely compromised because we have interfered in the nature and environment. Give me yes or no answer. Is nature intelligent? Give me yes or no. Is nature intelligent? And is it more intelligent than human being? Everybody agrees nature is intelligent. Yes, of course it is intelligent. But it is not more intelligent than human stupidity. We can beat nature with our stupidity to such an extent that nature is not able to overcome our stupidity. And that's why nature is suffering, because of our stupidity. Now, why do I say nature is intelligent? Look at this coconut. The tree grows to 100 feet tall, and the coconut has to fall from that height, and the seed of the new plant is embedded within the coconut, and the nature has ensured that even it falls from 100 feet, the seed does not get damaged. So it has encased the seed within a nice, spongy, fibrous outer shell and a very hard, rock-like inner shell, with a small opening where a soft eye-like thing is there, so that when the seed has to sprout, it can push it and come out. So nature has ensured that its seed is available for propagating its own species. Same thing with another plant called a cashew plant. A cashew fruit, a yellow color, is the one which can be eaten. But if you try to eat the seed, which is below that, I think this is the only species where the seed is outside the fruit. That shell, which is that gray colored thing, is full of acidic sap, acidic juice. Agar kaatoge to deep jal jayega. एनिमल भी काटना है कर सकता है, ह्यूमन बींग उसको चला के उसको कट कर सकता है, लेकिन मुंह से नहीं कट सकता, ताकि दी सीड इज सेफ फॉर इट्स प्रोपोगेशन. तो नेचर इज सो इंटेलिजेंट. इन द एनिमल स्पीशीज द स्नेक्स they have to go through bushes and thorns etc. They know their outer skin gets damaged, so over a period of time they have to shed that old skin and get a new skin. So this actual photograph taken from my own compound where the rat snake has shed its skin so that it can grow a new skin, so it can remain healthy for some more years. So nature has ensured survival of the species. This is a small plant. There is small seeds are contained in this. So when anyone passes through that place, if you are wearing a pant, it sticks to your pants, trouser. If it, an animal goes, it sticks to the leg of the animal. So that when the animal goes there and tries to shake it off, the seed gets fallen, falls there, and from there a new plant sprouts. So nature has made sure that it can propagate itself. Left to itself, a jungle can grow from nowhere. It doesn't require any human intervention. Unfortunately, there's one more example. This is called the Giloy plant. It's also called Amritavalli, and that is used in the treatment of diabetes. And it is a plant which increases your immunity, and especially during the COVID days. Just boil some leaves and drink it, the immunity boosts. Now, it is called Amritavalli. Amrita stands for no death. So, by mistake, this is my own, my house and this backyard. By mistake, because I require it for my kashaya, that is khada, to boil it and drink for immunity purpose, I cut it from here. That is, the root is here somewhere down below. Now, if you cut a plant from here, that means this part of the plant is without any water supply and nutrition supply. Any other plant has to dry. But no, this plant started a small hair-like thing. It grew. It went all the way to the ground. And then it pierced inside the ground. And then it grew as another root below and a branch here. So though it has cut from here, it started its own branch automatically, and this took almost 2 months. That means for 2 months, this has to survive itself from the moisture in the atmosphere. So nature has ensured the survival of the species. But unfortunately, estimate the stupidity of human being. To what extent a human being can be stupid? Because we didn't realize that human beings will not allow. We as human beings, do we allow that to keep the balance? The answer, unfortunately, is no. And how are we damaging the environment? How are we damaging the biodiversity? Simple things which you think that you have to be an environmentalist to do solve problems. No. Next time go to the market, please take a plastic, don't take a plastic bag. Please take your own cloth bag. You go to the market, half a dozen bananas, the shopkeeper will be very happy to give one plastic bag. Adha kilo tomato, aur ek plastic bag. Char anda, aur ek plastic bag. आधा किलो मच्छी और एक डबल प्लास्टिक बैग. कहां जाएगा प्लास्टिक? प्लास्टिक जाएगा कूड़े में. एंड यू कैन सी दिस सीनरी इन एवरी सिटीज, टाउन, इवन इन विलेजेस. एडेड टू दैट वी हैव काउज. दे कम एंड ट्राई टू ईट व्हाट इज इनसाइड द प्लास्टिक. They are not able to remove the plastic from the vegetable leftovers which is inside. So they gulp the plastic, and one cow died, and it has found that it has got some 20 kilos of plastic inside its stomach. So So who is harming the cows? And when you harm the cows, and who drinks the milk? We only drink the milk. Slowly the plastic from the stomach, some molecule definitely will get into the bloodstream of the cow, which gets into the milk, and then we boil milk and we have nice ice cream. And ultimately, who gets cancer? We get the cancer because we didn't think twice before going to the market barehanded and asking the shopkeeper, give me plastic, give me plastic. So we must have a change of behavior. So in my house, I have been in this house, the natural, this is just behind my house. I've been here for the last 5 years. I lived in Cochin, Andamans, Bombay, Delhi, Goa, and finally Bangalore, Pune. And finally, after 40 years of roaming around, I finally came to my ancestral village. My grandfather had given me some property, considered house here. And here I found out that who will collect my garbage? There is no municipality here, and that doesn't have a facility. And if you throw the garbage just outside, the dogs and rats population increases. So I said, okay, these are the six pipes which are there. Open from this side and open from this side. It is just half a foot inside the ground. So we put all the garbage inside. So I start with this pipe. Keep putting garbage here. So typically in 1 month it gets finished. I just close this and I start this one. Then it finishes, I close this. Then I start this one. Then I start this one. When I come to here, it's almost 6 months. In 6 months, this garbage, which is a food waste, not plastic, food waste, cooked as well as uncooked food waste. This has become proper fertilizer. That means I am not wasting even the waste food, but that becomes without any smell, without any rat population, without any dogs, stray dogs population increasing, without any flies and mosquitoes. I have produced manure out of my waste food. Imagine if every household does this one, there won't be requirement of any garbage trucks. So this is called pipe composting. If you don't do that, you'll get... I'm staying very close to the Arabian Sea. My house is just half a kilometer from here. And we are just this Tauteh cyclone 2-3 weeks back. And the sea actually came 100 meters towards my house. From 1,000 meters, it came closer 100 meters. Imagine it comes another 100 meters inside. And thereafter, it won't take any time to reach my house because it's all plain land. Another more severe cyclone coming. Another 2 feet increase in the wave height. It will reach my front yard. Like the peacock has already come, the wave will come. So, who is responsible for this thing? Arabian Sea is getting more and more cyclones because they have said Arabian Sea temperatures have gone up. Otherwise, Arabian Sea used to get only 20% of the cyclones in the Northern Indian Ocean. 5 cyclones in Bay of Bengal, 1 cyclone in Arabian Sea. But now it is becoming more, and it has become more and more stronger. More temperature means more evaporation. More evaporation means stronger is the winds. And we had two. We had Tauteh here and immediately asked them. We are going to get more and more of these cyclones. And I spent my entire professional life in predicting cyclones and predicting their path which they are going to take. We are all the meteorologists and oceanographers. My field is also oceanography. I predicted that next 50 years we are going to get more and more violent weather phenomena. And we say, okay, we got COVID, we should put gloves. Okay, you wear gloves, but what do you do with the gloves? We throw it. It gets into the water bodies. And that poor fish gets into that, it can't breathe. So we are the ones who are creating all the problems for biodiversity. Vulture population between 90 to 2007, see unprecedented decline of 99%. What is the reason? I was told that some of you are from medical background, paramedical background, pharmacy background. Diclofenac, is a medicine which was initially developed for humans because it is a painkiller. If you got joint pain, diclofenac will reduce that pain. So the livestock owners, the owners of bullock carts, the owners of horse carts, owners of donkeys, they found that if you give diclofenac to the animal will keep on working because it doesn't understand there's a pain. But ultimately, it will die. But so much of diclofenac in its blood, the dead body also contains that. And vultures are supposed to eat the dead bodies of animals. When vultures eat the dead bodies of vultures, their kidney fails. And because of their kidney failure, vulture population has been destroyed. You can say, hey, vulture, how does it matter? Now, vulture is required because vultures clean up the environment of the dead animals. When vultures are not there, the dead animals will keep on rotting. Rotting will give rise to flies. The flies will bring diseases. So these are the ones which clean up the environment. So if we clean up the environment of the vultures, who is there to do the scavenging part? So we are responsible for even vulture population destruction. Now I said environment is intelligent. Yes. Has its limitations. It cannot grow overnight. It has its time limitations. You take a simple rose flower. This I took from my own veranda. Simple rose blossoming. You can't tell, oh, no, tomorrow is my wife's birthday. I want a rose tomorrow. Jo karna karo, lekin kal mujhe rose mangta hai. Order de sakta hai kya? Nahi de sakte hai. Rose ka pehle bud banega, but thoda khilega, aur thoda khilega, finally banega. And iske liye ek hafta chahiye. You can't do fast forward of that. Similarly, bees dalo, hey, kal, I mean, chili ka mujhe, kal, chicken chili chahiye mujhe, chicken green masala chahiye, mujhe green chili chahiye kal, chalo, chili de do. Nahi aayega. De, ek seed dalo, char din mein thoda sa sprout aana lagega. Aur char din mein aur thoda badh jayega. Then day 12 like this, day 16 like this. After another 1 month, उसका फ्लावर आएगा और उसके बाद चिल्ली आएगा. नेचर हैज टू टेक इट्स ओन टाइम बट आवर स्टुपिडिटी इज नॉट अलाउिंग द नेचर टू गिव इट ओन टाइम. दैट इज अनफॉर्चुनेट पार्ट. दैट इज वेयर नेचर ने मार खाया. उसने सोचा नहीं था कि इधर ह्यूमन स्पीशीज भी आएगा जिसका स्टुपिडिटी हमारे इंटेलिजेंस से बढ़ा रहे. तो नेचर इज पेइंग the price for its own lack of foresight that human beings can destroy the environment. Because it takes time to renew. It cannot happen overnight. And because we are interfering with nature, all this, and then it is hitting us badly. Chhodta nahi ho. Because nature will survive next 1 lakh years also. Usko human being ki koi zarurat nahi hai. वो ह्यूमन बीइंग के बिना भी इतना साल रहा. ह्यूमन बीइंग के बिना भी और मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स रहेगा. कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. तो वो मारेगा. कैसे मारेगा? साइक्लोन क्रिएट करेगा. तुम मेरा टेम्परेचर बढ़ाओ तो मैं साइक्लोन दूंगा. और तुम्हारा सिटी में जा तुम बड़ा बड़ा घना घर बना कर रखा है भुख तो अभी हर साल आऊंगा. एक बार नहीं 5 साल आऊंगा. और जब भी आऊंगा पिछले साल से ज्यादा पावरफुल जाके आओगे. नेचर विल गिव इट दैट. नो डाउट अबाउट इट. चलो पेड़ काटते हैं पैसा बनता है. फॉरेस्ट है नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. इन द चैट बॉक्स लेट मी नो व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ फॉरेस्ट कवर. फॉरेस्ट कवर से क्या फायदा है? क्या चाहिए? इतना हम बिल्डिंग बना सकते हैं ना. फॉरेस्ट खाली जगह छोड़ के क्या फायदा है? प्यूरिफाई द सराउंडिंग, करेक्ट. व्हाई? आंसर इज राइट, एयर. एयर में भी स्पेसिफिक क्या देता है? पेड़ से क्या मिलता है? ऑक्सीजन. और जिंदगी भर में जाऊं जितना हमने ऑक्सीजन के बारे में बात नहीं किया उतना अभी शायद एक साल में किया, शायद 3 महीने में किया. ऑक्सीजन, थैंक यू सो मच एवरीबॉडी. ऑक्सीजन तो पेड़ काटो. अभी ऑक्सीजन एनवायरनमेंट में कम नहीं हुआ होगा या सिटी में कम भी हुआ होगा, बिकॉज नाउ इट हैज बिकम अ फैशन टू हैव ऑक्सीजन बार्स इन द सिटीज. थोड़ा थक गया, चलो ऑक्सीजन बार में जाते हैं, थोड़ा ऐसा सुनने को मिलता है ऑक्सीजन, प्योर ऑक्सीजन. तो नौबत अभी इट हैज नॉट कम टू द एंटायर सिटी, बट देयर इज वन, इट विल कम. एग्जांपल भेज हम अभी हवा में है, लेकिन मैं एक सैंपल भेजता हूं. अगर मेरा पूरा तुम काटोगे, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बढ़ता रहेगा इन द एटमॉस्फेयर, उसको ऑक्सीजन में रिकन्वर्ट करने के लिए पेड़ नहीं रहेंगे, तो तुम्हें ऑक्सीजन का प्रोडक्शन यू हैव टू मेक इट इन फैक्ट्रीज, बिकॉज यू कैन मेक ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम वाटर, H2O. यू ब्रेक अप द हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन, यू गेट ऑक्सीजन, बट दैट इज नॉट नेचुरल प्रोसेस, यू हैव टू गो टू द फैक्ट्रीज. So there may be a time, maybe 100 years from now, where today you are waiting for a gas cylinder to come for your cook, for cooking purposes. You may have to wait for a gas cylinder filled with oxygen to come to your home. Then only oxygen nahi mila is baar ka. So phone kar dein. Oxygen, BPCL ke jaise Oxygen Corporation of India. हमारा ऑक्सीजन नहीं है, हम दम घुट रहा है इधर, कल से हम ऑक्सीजन बिना एक ऑक्सीजन चार लोग यूज कर रहे हैं. वो नौबत आएगा, दैट कंडीशन विल कम, बिकॉज वी हैव मेड द फॉरेस्ट इनटू दिस लॉग्स. दे आर कटिंग डाउन ट्रू फुल फॉरेस्ट एंड देन वी विल हैव अ सप्लाई, वेयर वी विल हैव टू वेट फॉर अ सप्लाई. राइट नाउ इट इज ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ कोरोना, मे बी 100 इयर्स डाउन द लाइन इट कैनॉट बी बिकॉज ऑफ कोरोना, इट इज बिकॉज एक्चुअली देयर इज नो ऑक्सीजन इन द एटमॉस्फेयर. बिकॉज जिसको जो कर सकते थे उसको कन्वर्शन फ्रॉम कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड टू ऑक्सीजन, वो सब मारे गए हमारे हाथों में. तो टाइम टू इवन वेक अप नाउ एंड डू आवर बिट. अभी तुम लोग सोचते हो क्या कर सकते, हमारे हाथ में क्या है? ठीक है, आपने बोला प्लास्टिक नहीं, ठीक है प्लास्टिक नहीं लेंगे, लेकिन हम भूल गए ना आज, फॉरगॉट टू टेक द बैग. मैं क्या करूं? डोंट फॉरगेट, डू योर बिट. Don't use straws, because the straws get into the water bodies. When you get milk plastic, cut it nicely. Don't take it into 2 pieces. Just थोड़ा सा छेद करो, so that it does the small part doesn't go outside. And then sell it, because that can be recycled. Wash करके sell करो, so that much you're reducing. घर में uncooked vegetable waste है, 4-5 flower pot रखो और उसमें डालते रहो. It becomes manure without the right compost. It becomes manure for the individual flower pots. I done that when I was in Mumbai flats. Didn't have to throw anything. I was in Antarctica. Antarctica is to be saved as an environment. There is a treaty with 50 countries. Even the toilet waste is not to be wasted there. People stay there for one full year. The toilet waste is burnt there. And that ash is brought back, because we do not want to spoil the environment, because the toilet waste will remain the toilet waste for next 2000 years, because the temperature is minus 60 there. So we bring it back, so that in Antarctica at least should not get spoiled. So when Antarctica gets spoiled, ice shelf will melt, ice, the glaciers will break, they will get into the ocean level will go up, countries like Maldives will disappear, Arabian Sea temperature will go up, and finally will have cyclones come into my village, my house. So aap log bol sakte hain ki hum kya kar sakte hain. Ek ladka tha, wo beach mein chal raha tha, chalte chalte he used to get some starfish. To starfish lega, usko fekega samundar mein, aur ek starfish mila, usko fekega. To hamare jaise ek budda aadmi bola, क्या कर रहे हो तुम बीच बीच में? यू आर पिकिंग अप समथिंग एंड थ्रोइंग इट टू ओशन, क्या क्या कर रहे हो? एंड द बॉय सेड, अंकल देखो ना इधर स्टारफिश, इट केम ड्यूरिंग द रिटायर्ड, दे केम इनटू द सैंड, अभी वो दे आर स्टक इन द सैंड, इज सन हैज बिकम हॉट एंड सन इज बिकमिंग कन्वर्टिंग द सैंड इनटू हॉट बर्निंग सैंड, उधर रहेगा तो मर जाएंगे ना. सो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग इज आई एम पिकिंग अप वन बाय वन एंड थ्रोइंग इट टू ओशन, ताकि वो तुम्हारा एक दो पिकअप करने से क्या फर्क पड़ेगा? द बॉय डिड नॉट से एनीथिंग, पिक्ड अप वन मोर स्टारफिश, थ्रू इट इन द ओशन एंड सेड, अंकल इसको फर्क पड़ा? हम सारे प्रॉब्लम को सॉल्व नहीं कर सकते हैं, वी आर नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स, लेट अस सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट वी कैन सॉल्व, दैट इज व्हाट आई एम आस्किंग यू विथ फोल्डेड हैंड, डू योर बिट, डोंट कंसिडर माय लेक्चर एज अ ज्ञान सेशन. एनवायरमेंट डे को मना लिया हमने, एक लेक्चर सुन लिया विजय कुमार से, चलो अगला एनवायरमेंट डे और कुछ सुनते हैं. नहीं, इसमें जो कुछ भी आप एक चीज जो कर सकते हो, दैट विल बी योर कंट्रीब्यूशन टू द एनवायरनमेंट, एंड दैट इज द एंड ऑफ माय सेशन, एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग, सो दैट यू गेट एन एनवायरनमेंट लाइक द वन बिहाइंड मी. दिस इज नॉट माय हाउस, दिस इज ए वर्चुअल बैकग्राउंड. But we want environment like clear blue skies, clear blue water, green trees, and a beautiful, fragrant air. That is what is going to happen if we take proper measures. Over to you, Halimaji. I kept my time.
Wow, wonderful. What a presentation. It was mind-blowing. It was eye-opener. It was full of message, what we all have to do. And I request all the participants to give a big round of applause to the guest speaker today.
Thank you.
Commander Vijay Kumar ji. Thank you very much for sparing your valuable time. And thank you for compiling such informative presentation. Really, we all are honored and we all have been benefited by your talk. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, you all must be waiting for the event that is very attractive for everyone. Login and win. But before starting login and win, let me just share a few slides with you. And these slides is important for us to share because this program in which we all are here is organized by DPMI Darbhanga. You all know DPMI Darbhanga. So what exactly is DPMI Darbhanga? DPMI Darbhanga was established in 1996. And this is the franchisee taken from Delhi. And DPMI Darbhanga is one of the most prestigious institute where you find that different paramedical courses are offered. And you can see that here not only the children learn or complete their courses, but a special emphasis is on their personality development. So here they learn operation theater technology. Before that, it was medical laboratory technology. And then they learned radio imaging technology. And they learned different engineering and medical courses. And since here, the emphasis is on quality and on personality building and character building. So that's why there are limited seats available. And one more good news is that DPMI Darbhanga offers the scholarships on the basis of merit come mean. So if you are eligible, if you are, if you think that you can manage these courses and you have the capability of learning or enrolling yourself for these courses, but you don't have the fees to deposit, in that case, you can always apply for the scholarship quota. There you have to appear for the test. And if you qualify in the test, then you will be getting the scholarship from DPMI Darbhanga. After completion of these courses, not only you are going to get the job immediately in your city, in your state, or in any state of India or in our country, but you can get the jobs even in abroad. Like you can, you are eligible to work in USA, in Australia, Canada, New Zealand, UK, and Gulf countries. Since DPMI Darbhanga has the connections with the institutions, with the hospitals, nursing home, and diagnostic centers in all these countries. And it is managed by well-qualified, experienced, and dedicated teaching faculty. The institute itself is well-furnished. Smart classrooms are there. It is a well-equipped laboratory and well-stocked and updated library. And focus is on soft skill and personality development that I have already mentioned to you. One-to-one mentoring and collaboration with many companies. So ladies and gentlemen, DPMI Darbhanga has organized this important program today just to make the people aware of their environment, the environmental concern, and our responsibility. On this occasion, I would like to give a good news to you too. There are many students who must have completed their courses, and they must be thinking that instead of joining some job, they want to do their own, they want to start their own startups. For such type of children, there is a good news. Since DPMI Darbhanga has collaboration with many institutes and many groups, many communities. So we have a community in Singapore that is called ACE International. And ACE International provides Global Entrepreneurship Guild. And under this, the children who are interested for their startups, they have the pitching opportunity. So you can use this opportunity, pitching opportunity on 7th June at 7 p.m. You have to contact us, and there is no fees for this pitching opportunity. You will be guided and you will be given proper advice that how you have to plan for your startups, how your pitching should be for the funding or for the networking, and all our resource persons are going to guide you in this regard. So thank you very much for being with us. Today the response is too high, and I know that this is because of our eminent speaker, and I am grateful of the eminent speaker for being this morning with us. And now we have come to the most attractive part of our program, and the most attractive part is today's quiz that carries cash award, login and win. For this, I would like to invite my colleagues, my friends, those who are going to help me here. So Maryam Firdaus is going to be the presenter of quiz. Farooq sir is going to be the facilitator of the technology. And Mr. Altaf is going to be the recorder. That those who are going to answer correctly, their records will be maintained, and they will be asked to provide their Paytm number, Google Pay or Pay phone, any number if you have, so that your cash award will be transferred then and there. So Fatima ma'am, are you ready? Maryam Firdaus ma'am, are you ready?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so before we share the first question, Vijay Kumar ji is also here. Thank you very much. So before going for this quiz, let me announce the rules. The rule is that the question will be appeared on the screen. You have to read the question. There are four options. One of that option is correct. So there are options written as A, B, C, D. Please read the options very carefully and then you write the correct option in the chat box. The first correct option shared by the participant will be considered as the winner. I think that the rules are clear. So that is the reason why I said that you all must use your proper name, because when you are interacting through the chat box, your proper name should be visible, that should be displayed. If you all are ready for this quiz, please write in the chat box that yes, you are ready. Okay, wonderful. So, here we go, Maryam. Please share the first question.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible and your screen is also visible.
Okay. So I'm sharing the first question now. What is greenhouse effect?
There are four options available. Out of that, one option is correct option. And I have already received the correct option by Urusa Ashfaq. Urusa Ashfaq, congratulations. You have given the first correct answer. Option A is the correct answer, trapping of heat radiation from Earth. And winner of this round of this first question is Urusa Ashfaq. Farooq sir, please contact Urusa Ashfaq and collect her Paytm number and transfer the award money of rupees 100. Each question carries 100 rupees. Urusa Ashfaq, congratulations. Mr. Farooq, are you there? Mr. Altaf?
Yeah, ma'am. Let me connect her and ask her details. Okay, I am on it.
Yes, please. Before we go for the second question, we all have to be very careful. And if winners, you are getting the cash awards, please let me know so that I can call you on the screen to get your feedback. Now, second question. Yes, Maryam, please.
Which is a greenhouse gas?
So, second question's correct answer is option D, carbon dioxide. And Lalit Kumar Yadav has given this answer first. Congratulations, Lalit Kumar Yadav. Congratulations to Lalit Kumar Yadav. Please contact Mr. Altaf and Mr. Farooq through chat box and provide them with your Paytm, Google Pay or payphone number. Congratulations to Lalit Kumar. Yes, Maryam, third please.
What excuse is the main me. Constituent
okay, continue.
Of acid rain?
Just a minute. Again, Maryam, please repeat.
What is the main constituent of acid rain?
And the correct option is B, all of the above. And the first correct answer is given by Shahnawaz Alam. Shahnawaz, it is written Shahnawaz Alam. Shahnawaz, congratulations to you. You are the first person to answer this question correctly. And please contact Altaf sir and Farooq sir. Give them.
Yeah, ma'am. Before going to question number four, I will request Miss Ulisa and Lalit Kumar and Mr. Spark to share their detail in my personal direct message, as they didn't shared me, or even they shared me due to the high message I couldn't get it. So right now, before going to fourth question, can you share right now your detail, please?
Mr. Altaf, I request you that you send them the personal message.
I already sent them, but actually they didn't reply me back.
Okay. Before going to fourth, may I request Urusa, Shahnawaz,
Lalit, and Lalit Kumar.
And which Lalit Kumar?
Lalit Kumar, yeah.
Yes, please provide your details to Altaf sir.
Urusa, can you share me like personal? You are just sending in the everyone list. Can you share me?
Don't share it with everyone, because everyone, there is so much, so many messages are there. It will be lost somewhere. Send to Altaf sir's personal direct message. Send to Mr. Altaf's personal message. You go to.
Yeah, I got.
Yes, you got okay. It from all yeah. Of them.
No. Just Urusa has sent me. Lalit Kumar, yeah, Urusa and Lalit Kumar both have sent me. And third one is.
Shahnawaz, please share with Altaf sir your details. Mr. Shahnawaz, congratulations. Moving to the fourth question. Yes, Mariam.
When was the problem of ozone hole first identified?
So the correct option is here. Yes, I can see the correct option is 1985. That is C option, and it is given by Rahim A. Rahim. Congratulations, Rahim A. Rahim. Rahim A. Rahim, congratulations to you. Please contact Mr. Altaf and provide your personal details to Mr. Altaf on the direct message. Congratulations.
Rahim A. Rahim, can you share the text please as soon as possible?
Now question number five.
What is the function of ozone layer?
Yes, the correct answer is the first option, stop harmful ultraviolet rays from reaching Earth. And this correct answer is given by Gulmuazzam Fazi. He is the first one to give this correct answer. Congratulations, Gulmuazzam Fazi. Please contact Altaf Sahab and send your personal details with your name to Mr. Altaf in direct message. Gulmuazzam Fazi, congratulations.
Before going to next question, we have to wait for both of them because both of them didn't send me. Like, yeah, Gulmuazzam Fazi sent me, but Mr. Rahim A. Rahim and Shahnawaz still didn't share me the detail.
Mr. A. Rahim and Mr. Shahnawaz.
Okay, yeah, we got Rahim A. Rahim. Mr. Shahnawaz, you are waiting right now. Can you share the details, please, as soon as possible?
Otherwise, you will not get your award.
Yeah, ma'am, we can continue. I didn't get Shahnawaz.
Now, question number six.
Which of the following does not cause atmospheric pollution?
So answer of this question is option A, that is hydrogen. And the correct answer given is by Mohammed Rafiuz Zama. Congratulations, Mohammed Rafiuz Zama. You are the first one to send the correct answer of this question, question number 6, Mohammad Rafiuz Zama. Please share your details with Mr. Altaf and Farooq. Mohammad Rafiuz Zama. And please, nobody use this chat box right now for any other purpose except for question answers. Or if you have to send any message to anyone, please send them direct message. For everyone, don't send any message that is going to divert our attention and that's going to spoil the flow.
Yeah, Mr. Rafiuz Zama, can you share me detail directly instead of telling me hi? Can you share the detail directly? Share your Google Pay, Phone Pay, Paytm, any contact, please. Yeah, sure. Thank you, Rafiuz Zama. We can continue.
Now, question number 7.
The film Happy Feet features a species of penguins that inhabit the continent of Antarctica. Name this species of penguin.
So the correct answer of this question is option C, emperor penguin, and it's given by Maria. Congratulations, Maria. You are the first one to send the correct answer of this question. Maria, please share your details. Send your details to Mr. Altaf in direct message. Maria, congratulations once again. Yes, Mariam, 8.
Kaziranga National Park is in which state?
So the correct answer of this question is option C, Assam. And we have received the correct answer by Gul Muazzam Fazi. Congratulations, Gul Muazzam Fazi. You are the first one to send the correct answer. That is option C. Gul Muazzam Fazi, please share your details with Mr. Altaf. Gul Muazzam Fazi. And when I am announcing the result, then after that, nobody is allowed to send any option. Because once result is announced, there is no use of sending your options. Now, question number 9.
Which animal is found in abundance in Kaziranga National Park?
So the correct answer of this question is option A. And option A is given by A. Rahim. A. Rahim. Congratulations. A. Rahim is the second winner, second time winner. Congratulations, A. Rahim. Please share your details. The correct answer is option A, rhino.
Can get hello the detail of Maria. Can you share me the detail, please, Maria? The last question winner. Still we didn't get your detail.
Maria, please share your details. And Gul Muazzam has shared in the common platform. I hope you receive the details of Maria. And all the winners, please stay on with us. You will get the chance to share your experience with us. We are going to give you 30 seconds time to share your experiences here. Now, question number 10. Yes, Mariam.
Which is the biggest national park for tigers?
So the correct answer of this question is option A, that is Corbett. And the correct answer given is by Gul Muazzam. Congratulations, Gul Muazzam. You are getting second time award. Gul Muazzam has sent us the correct option. He was the first one to send option A. Congratulations, Gul Muazzam. So I think the participants must be enjoying and must be happy to see how innovative and creative is DPMI Darbhanga and how DPMI Darbhanga is concerned about the environment. That's why this quiz is being conducted, so that we all should be aware of our environment. Now coming to question number 11. Yes, Mariam.
In which state is the Gir Lions Park?
Yes, we have received large number of, like, immediately within no time we are receiving 40 answers. Oh my God, so enthusiastic participants I have seen first time. Congratulations. And the first person to send the correct answer is option D, Gujarat, and it is sent by Aminul Islam. Congratulations, Aminul Islam. Please share your details with Altaf sir, Aminul Islam. And now question number 12.
Which country is currently suffering from uncontrollable rat population?
Wow, so without even completing the question, the correct answer is ready. I'm surprised how genius the people are nowadays. The first correct answer is given by Nishi Sharma. The correct option is B, that is Australia. And Nishi Sharma, congratulations to you. You are the first one to send us the correct option. Nishi Sharma, please share your details with Mr. Altaf on his direct message, please. Nishi Sharma, congratulations.
Nishi Sharma, can you share me the detail soon? Yeah, we get it. We can continue, ma'am.
Yes, now question number 13.
In which state is Corbett National Park located?
In which state? Okay, so the correct option is C, and we have received from Haya Fatima. Congratulations, Haya Fatima. C is the correct answer, Uttarakhand. Haya Fatima, please share your details with Altaf sir on his direct message. Haya Fatima, congratulations. I'm amazed with the intelligence of today's generation. Really, it's amazing to see the performances of the children. DPMI Darbhanga will be happy to have such intelligent children in DPMI Darbhanga's institute. You see, 15 I have not even shared, and question is not shared and answers I am receiving. That is false play. Okay? I am appreciating your intelligence, and you are showing me your stupid aspect of your personality. Yes, 15 questions, please.
What is India's national animal?
And to my surprise, most of them have written wrong answers. 15 ka answer wrong.
Ma'am, this is question 14.
India's national animal is question 14?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I'm sorry for that. Let me see now. So the correct option is B. And again, Haya Fatima is the one who has sent the correct answer.
Haya Fatima, can you share me? Yeah, yes, can you share me the details?
He's
in person.
Congratulations, Haya Fatima. Mariam, if I'm not wrong, this is going to be 15, isn't it?
Yeah, the next one will be 15.
Excuse me, ma'am. Before starting, I will request Haya Fatima to share her detail as like we didn't receive it yet.
Haya Fatima, please share your details. Haya Fatima. May I request Haya Fatima?
Just share your Google Pay or Phone Pay, any type of detail. Google Pay, Phone Pay, Paytm, anything you have. Or account detail, anything. So that we can transfer the prize money. Can you do it soon, please?
Just a minute. Please wait. I have to... Yes, so now 15.
Smog is related to the pollution of
Is it so difficult? Yes, so the correct option is D, and the first person to answer it correctly is Gul Muazzam Faizi. Congratulations, Gul Muazzam Faizi. Please share your details with Altaf sir. Congratulations, Gul Muazzam Faizi. Yes, 16 now, please.
Sewage water can be purified for recycling with the action of
Yes. So the correct option is option C. And the participant who has shared this correct option is Imran. Congratulations, Imran. Microorganism is the correct answer. And Imran has sent this correct answer. He is the first one to send this correct answer. Imran, please share your details with Altaf sir. Congratulations, Imran. Now 17.
Taj Mahal is threatened due to the effect of
So the correct option is option B, sulfur dioxide. And the first participant to share this correct option is Aminul Islam. Congratulations, Aminul Islam. You are receiving second time, if I am not wrong. Congratulations, Aminul Islam. Please share your details with Altaf sir. Now 18.
Which of the following is not produced as exhaust of vehicles?
See, this Yalghar is so clever. He is answering 2, 2, 3, 3 options. So that will be invalid. You have to only choose one answer. So I have received an instruction from the organizers that those who have already got the prizes, we have to include more participants in this. So the correct answer is option D. And the award receiver is Amal Manoj. Congratulations, Amal Manoj. Please share your details with the organizers. Amal Manoj, congratulations. Now only 2 more questions to go. So all those who are excited and who are willing to receive the cash awards, please be vigilant, be quick, and always try for the right answer. Amal Manoj, please share your details with Altaf sir. Amal Manoj. Amal Manoj, please share your details. Now question number 19.
The sound above what level is considered harmful?
Correct option is C, and it is given by Sadaf Jahan. Congratulations, Sadaf Jahan. Sadaf Jahan, please share your details with Altaf sir. Sadaf Jahan, please share your details with Altaf sir.
Amal, Manoj, and Sadaf Jahan, can you share me the detail as soon as possible? I would like. You didn't share me yet.
Sadaf Jahan and
Amal Manoj.
Amal Manoj, please share your details.
I got from Amal Manoj. Sadaf Jahan, can you share me as well?
Sadaf Jahan, please share the details. Sadaf Jahan, please share the details. And now, the last question, question number 20.
Ozone hole is caused by
Yes, the correct answer is option A, and the winner is Zeba Nishat. Congratulations, Zeba Nishat. Please share your details with Altaf sir. Zeba Nishat.
Zeba Nishat and Sadaf Jaha both kindly share the detail as soon as possible so we can compile Sadaf everything.
Sadaf Jaha and Zeba Nishat, please share your details. Thank you very much, Maryam Firdaus. Thank you very much, Altaf sir. Thank you very much, Farooq sir. Now we are going to have the sharing session where the winners are going to share their experiences. How was it when they were answering the questions? May I request you, Maryam, to kindly stop sharing? Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now, among the winners, please share your names with us. Please raise your hands if you want to share. If you want to share your experiences, please raise your hand. Yes, Lalit Kumar. Yes, Lalit Kumar.
Yes, hello. I am Lalit.
Lalit Kumar ji, kaisa lag raha hai?
बहुत बढ़िया मैम. जैसा कि आपने कहा था कि बहुत ही मीन्स बहुत ही अच्छे लोगों के साथ, यानी जिनके पास बहुत ही ज्यादा नॉलेज था. ऐसा नहीं था कि बिल्कुल भी जिसके पास है, इवन सबके पास ही था, बट एक बहुत ही अच्छा टाइमिंग का भी यहाँ पे हमें ध्यान रखना था. तो सबने बहुत अच्छा खेला और काफी कुछ हमने इससे सीखा. और आपने कई बार ऐसे क्विजेस का ऑर्गेनाइज करते रहते हैं, तो इसके लिए मैं आपको थैंक यू बोलना चाहूंगा.
You are most welcome, Lalit. It's so nice. And you know, these words are always very motivating for us. Thank you very much. And now let me invite Rahim. Yes, Rahim. Rahim.
Thanks, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Kaisa lag raha aapko?
Ji, ma'am, bahut acha lag raha hai, ma'am. So interesting, bahut acha raha.
तो आपको उम्मीद थी कि आप जीत पाएंगे?
जी मैम, मुझे तो बहुत उम्मीद था. ऐसा मुझे लग नहीं रहा था लेकिन कि मैं जीत पाऊंगा. लेकिन क्वेश्चन इज सो इजी.
ओके, क्वेश्चंस वर इजी, दैट्स व्हाई यू कुड विन. ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच, कांग्रेचुलेशंस. नाउ निशी शर्मा.
यस,
कैसा लग रहा है आपको?
Very nice experience, ma'am. First of all, I want to thank everyone who organized this wonderful competition. It is quite interesting and very fruitful. It is very knowledgeable. I am very glad that I participate in this. And the participants are very much energetic. They answer so fast so that I can lose my chances again and again. Overall, it was very interesting and very fruitful. Thank you so much.
You are welcome, Nishi, and congratulations once again. Hiya, thank Fatima. You. Thank you. Take care. Hiya, Fatima.
Assalamu alaikum, ma'am.
Walaikum assalam.
Ma'am, बहुत बहुत अच्छा लगा. हमें बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला environment day में. And बहुत easy question था, ma'am. जिससे कि बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला और मुझे ऐसा लग रहा था कि मैं भी जीत पाऊंगी. So thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Haya. And now let us move to Gul Muazzam. Yes, Gul Muazzam.
Yes, ma'am.
कैसा लग रहा है?
मैम बहुत अच्छा लगा. मैंने बहुत सारे आंसर दिए और बहुत अच्छी बात यह है कि आप एनवायरमेंट डे पे ये कराते हैं तो लोग इसके बारे जानते हैं. बहुत सारे लोग जो हैं गांव में इन चीजों के बारे नहीं जानते हैं, लेकिन अब जो है अब जैसे लोगों के कारण लोग इसके बारे जागरूक हो रहे हैं. और असल में हम लोग जो है कि इस बारे लोगों को जागरूक करने की जरूरत है. हम लोग इन चीजों को मजाक में ले लेते हैं, लेकिन ये जो है एनवायरनमेंट का जो कंसर्न है, जो सर जो इससे पहले जो सर कमांडर सर ने जो लेक्चर दिया, बहुत फ्रूटफुल था।
थैंक यू वेरी मच। एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव टू इमरान। यस इमरान।
अस्सलामु अलैकुम मैम।
वालेकुम अस्सलाम इमरान
जी। मैम ये कंपटीशन देख के बहुत अच्छा लगा, और ये फास्ट आंसर की वजह से मेरा बहुत चांस मिस भी हो गया। मेरा सही आंसर था लेकिन फास्ट आंसर की वजह से मेरा चांस मिस हो गया।
चलिए फिर भी मिला तो सही आपको।
जी जी
कांग्रेचुलेशंस।
थैंक यू मैम। थैंक यू।
नाउ कमिंग टू रफीउज जमा। यस रफीउज जमा। रफीउज जमा।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम मैम।
वालेकुम अस्सलाम
मैम। आज का जो कंपटीशन था बहुत अच्छा था, और शुरू शुरू में तो मेरा मोबाइल मैम हैंग करने लगा था, इसकी वजह से मैं दो चार क्वेश्चन पीछे रह गया। इंशाल्लाह अगले अगर क्यूज में आने की कोशिश करूंगा और अच्छे से आने की कोशिश करूंगा। और अभी मैं अभी ड्यूटी पे था, हॉस्पिटल में हूँ, तो पेपर भी आया आज, तो पेपर में भी देखा, और इससे पहले भी कल भी मैं प्रिपरेशन किया था, चूँकि फारूक सर ने भेज दिया था व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में, तो उसको देख के मैं प्रिपरेशन किया और क्यूज में भी लगाया।
Okay, so thank you very much. Now coming to Zeba Nishad. Yes, Zeba. Zeba, कैसा लग रहा आपको? आखिरकार finally आप winner हो गए, मैं देख रही थी. Zeba was trying in each and every question.
Yes, ma'am. Assalamu alaikum, ma'am.
Alaikum assalam.
Yes, ma'am. मैंने बहुत try किया और network problem की वजह से मैं भी पीछे हो गई, but मैंने try किया, finally I won. So I am very happy and thanks to you, ma'am. So thanks to you, ma'am, to given a golden opportunity to us. And thank you, ma'am, for this.
Okay, you are most welcome, my dear. Congratulations once again. And before we wind up our program, we have to present a token of our appreciation and to our commander, Vijay Kumar ji. So may I request Vijay Kumar ji to kindly accept a token of appreciation from all of us from DPMI Darbhanga.
Thank you, madam. Thank you so much. Honored to be able to speak to the young population, because they are the future citizens of the country and they are the ones who have to keep the environment in good shape for their own generation, next generations. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure and honor for us, Commander Saab. And now I request Dr. Kainat Saab, who is the principal of DPMI Darbhanga, and who is always concerned and who is always thoughtful about the progress of the children and the institute. And she is the one who organizes lots of medical camps, lots of cultural programs, lots of awareness programs. And she is very passionate, she is very compassionate, and she is very ambitious about this institution. So over to you, Dr. Kainat Saab.
Good afternoon, all of you. Commander Vijay sir, आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया। थैंक्स कि आज जो एनवायरनमेंट डे था इसको इस प्लेटफॉर्म पर आपने मनाया, और बहुत ही बारीकी से आपने एक एक चीज को उसमें स्पेसिफिक बच्चे को स्टूडेंट्स को बताया, जिनकी वजह से आज ये कमीशन जो प्लेटफॉर्म पर हुआ। क्योंकि बच्चे तो पढ़ते हैं नीचे क्लास में, लेकिन उनको जब वो आगे की ओर बढ़ने लगते हैं तो वो पीछे का चीज छोड़ने लगते हैं, वो पीछे नहीं जाते हैं देख करके कि इन्वायरमेंट में क्या नेचर में चेंज हो रहा है और हमें कैसे उससे इन्वायरमेंट को बनाकर रखना है। तो आज आपने इस प्लेटफॉर्म पर जो मैसेज दिया है, जो स्पीच आपकी थी वंडरफुल थी। आई थिंक बच्चे ने जो कम्पिटिशन अभी प्ले किया, यहाँ पर गेम प्ले किया, इसकी वजह से उन्हें बहुत ही अच्छा इम्पैक्ट पड़ा कि बच्चे अब जब भी वो पढ़ेंगे क्लास में तो वो 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 और पैरामेडिक्स तक बनने तक वो सारी चीज को गेन करके रखेंगे, याद करके रखेंगे। मैं उम्मीद करती हूँ कि वो भूलेंगे नहीं, क्योंकि बहुत इजी क्वेश्चन था और बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन था, लेकिन बच्चे ने बहुत कम टाइम में बहुत अच्छा किया, लेकिन बट वो भूल रहे थे कहीं ना कहीं, बी सी डी ऑप्शन गलत चूज कर रहे थे, क्योंकि उनको एक जस्ट लाइक क्वेश्चन का आंसर बिल्कुल बहुत ही मैच कर रहा था, तो उनको याद नहीं रहा होगा इस वजह से। और मैं डॉक्टर हलीमा सादिया को मैं बहुत ही तहे दिल से शुक्रिया अदा करती हूँ कि वो हमेशा इस तरह का गेम और पार्टिसिपेट हमेशा वो डीपीएमआई से जुड़ी रहती हैं, एक्टिव रहती हैं, और जितने भी यहाँ पर डायरेक्टर, पैनलिस्ट, फैकल्टी और स्टूडेंट्स, मैं सभी की तहे दिल से शुक्रिया करती हूँ। और मैं चाहती हूँ कि इसी तरह से आगे भी प्ले होता रहे, गेम होता रहे, और इस प्लेटफॉर्म पर बच्चे को नई नई चीज बताई जाए। बच्चे का इंटरेस्ट घर में रहते रहते वो बोर हो जाते हैं, तो मैं चाहती हूँ कि पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन में उन्हें कुछ न कुछ स्टडी, उनके पास मटेरियल, उनको इस तरह से कलेक्ट करने का एक जरिया बना रहे, और वो अपनी लाइफ को बोर ना समझे और वो कुछ इसमें आगे बढ़ते रहे। ये डीपीएमआई एक्चुअली डेली पैरामेडिकल मैनेजमेंट इंस्टीट्यूट है। यहाँ पर आप सभी को पैरामेडिकल के जितने भी स्टूडेंट है, पैरामेडिक्स यहाँ बनते हैं, और आप सभी के यहाँ पर जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं उनके भाई बहन, अगर उन्होंने इस साल 12th पास किया है तो उनको आप लोग बिल्कुल यहाँ पर, या 10th भी पास किया है तो उनको एडमिशन करवाइए, क्योंकि अभी की जो सिचुएशन है उसमें पैरामेडिक्स की बहुत जरूरत है। आपको जितने भी प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल है, गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल है, हर जगह वैकेंसी है, और अभी आने वाले टाइम में इन फ्यूचर ये हमेशा वैकेंसी रहेगी, कभी भी ये वैकेंसी खत्म नहीं होने वाली है। तो मैं चाहती हूँ कि अगर आप लोग मेडिकल लाइन से जाना चाहते हैं तो प्लीज आप लोग पैरामेडिकल में आए, और डीपीएमआई दरभंगा जो है वो काफी अच्छा है यहाँ पर डिम्स कैंपस के अंदर। यहाँ पर स्टडी आप लोग को बहुत ही अच्छी मिलेगी, साथ में हम लोग एक मेगना डायग्नोस्टिक सेंटर भी बच्चों के लिए अभी ओपन हाल फिलहाल में कमिंग सून है वो होने वाला है। तो यहाँ पर सारा प्रैक्टिकल भी है, थ्योरी भी है, सारी चीज है, और यहाँ पर फैकल्टी भी बेस्ट है। तो मैं सभी बच्चे से, जो बच्चे हैं हमारे उनसे मैं तहे दिल से शुक्रिया करती हूँ, जो हमारे बच्चे हैं उनसे, जो हमारे आउटसाइडर बच्चे हैं जो हमें नहीं जानते हैं, वो एक बार प्लीज आप लोग आए और इंस्टीट्यूट को विजिट करें। और थैंक्स फॉर एवरीवन, एस्पेशली कमांडर विजय सर, थैंक यू।
थैंक यू, थैंक यू वेरी मच कायनात साहिबा, इट वॉज रियली वेरी इनकरेजिंग टू लिसन अबाउट डीपीएमआई दरभंगा एंड अबाउट डिम्स कैंपस एंड अबाउट मेघना ऑल्सो। तो अब हम अपने प्रोग्राम के अख्ताम पे आ चुके हैं, लेकिन हम अपने बच्चों को डिप्राइव नहीं करेंगे इस अपॉर्चुनिटी से कि वो विजय कुमार जी से अगर कुछ इंटरेक्ट करना चाहते हैं, कुछ क्वेश्चंस उनके जहन में है, कुछ वो पूछना चाहते हैं। सो काइंडली रेज अप योर हैंड एंड देन एट द एंड वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ ग्रुप फोटोग्राफ विद कमांडर साहब। तो उस वक्त मैं आप सबसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगी कि अपने कैमरे को ऑन कर लें, लेकिन उससे पहले 3 क्वेश्चंस का ऑप्शन है, सिर्फ 3 क्वेश्चंस का मौका दिया जाएगा। जो पूछना चाहते हैं वो प्लीज रेज अप योर हैंड एंड लेट मी गिव यू द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू आस्क द क्वेश्चंस। कुछ भी अगर आपको कमांडर विजय जी से पूछना है, मालूम करना है, तो आउट ऑफ दिस माय 1 क्वेश्चन इज ऑलरेडी देयर, लेकिन मैं उसको नहीं शामिल करूंगी 3 में, वो मेरा 4th रहेगा। जो मैंने कहा था कमांडर साहब से कि मैं पूछूंगी आपसे कि जब आप अंटार्कटिका पे गए थे तो कैसा आपका एक्सपीरियंस रहा, चलिए उसी से स्टार्ट करते हैं, फिर बाद में बच्चों से लेते हैं कि बच्चे क्या पूछना चाहते हैं।
हम लोग निकले गोवा से, 3 हफ्ता लगता है जहाज में जाने के लिए अंटार्कटिका पहुंचने के लिए, और वापस आने के लिए 3 हफ्ता, 3 weeks टू 4 weeks था, एंड हमारा स्टे रहा होता 2.5 months, एंड वहां जब गए टेम्परेचर था -20 एंड स्लोली बिकमिंग टूवर्ड्स -60, एंड वी वेंट देयर, इट वाज समर बिकॉज इट इज विंटर हियर मंथ ऑफ नवंबर, बट देयर इट इज समर इन बीइंग द सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर, सो इट वाज 24 आवर्स ओनली सन इज देयर, देयर इज नो डार्कनेस, सो कंटिन्यूअसली फॉर 2.5 months इट वाज 1 फुल डे विदाउट एनी डार्कनेस, and the camp is about 100 kilometers inside the continent, so the ship will be at the place where the ice shelf is there, the ship will be tied to the ice shelf and we have to go 100 kilometers inside through the ice shelf, because one camp is there called Maitri, and that is a place where our permanent camp is there, scientific camp is there. There we leave 26 people, including scientists and the army people, for maintaining the camp. And we leave them and come back. And they remain for 16 months because they will be picked up in the next year. As of now, it is totally unpolluted. And you can see actually a distance of 100 kilometers because there is no air pollution. And sometimes when there is some typical weather phenomena, like we see these mirages here on the roads, using that mirage, same phenomena, you can see the camp which is 100 kilometers away in an elevated state. The 100 kilometers you can't see because the earth is curved, but because of the weather phenomena, it looks as if it is lifted. And you can see it from 100 kilometers. That shows it is purely, the air is so good without any pollutants. But when there are conditions called blizzards, where 2-3 days at a stretch, snow doesn't fall, snow flows horizontally. And it becomes zero visibility because the snow is flowing. And that phenomenon continues for 2-3 days. The temperature going up to minus 40, and with a wind chill factor, and the wind speed is about 300 kilometers per hour, nothing can stand there. In fact, in one of those episodes, our helicopter, which was tied with a chain, broke and the helicopter blade broke. But imagine the nature. Even in such strong conditions, the penguins which are there, they remain unaffected because they make huddles of thousands of them together, close to each other, continuously moving in and out like honeybees, so that one penguin gets only a few seconds into the open air and the chilly weather, and they're able to manage for 3 days. Because they can't even go to the sea because sea is almost getting frozen that time. So this is the wonder of nature that we can see. I mean, I was lucky that Indian Navy sent me there and made me stay for 2.5 months. And even after almost 40 years, the memory is still so fresh in my mind. It's a beautiful place. And one must maintain it for posterity because the ice shelf is breaking. Recently, one big ice shelf broke off the Antarctic island, all because of the global warming.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And I can see only Nishi has switched on the camera.
Ma'am, just I need to have an announcement. Like Mr. Shahnawaz Alam, can you share your Google Pay and number? Like you are only the one who left right now.
Shahnawaz.
I even message you in direct message and all there.
Mr. Shahnawaz, please share your details. So I can see only four cameras on. Okay, five camera on. Okay, great. Okay, six camera on. Seven on. So smile, please.
1 minute. Before that thing, let me show this photograph of mine in 1990 in that camp called Dakshin Gangotri, which was built about 10 years earlier to that. And now by the time I went, it was actually sinking to the ice. And then India made another camp called Maitri in the on the rock foundation. So this is me at the sinking Dakshin Gangotri. First camp, scientific camp of India.
Can't believe that. Is it you?
Yeah.
एक शेर याद आ गया. आई ना मुझसे मेरी पहली सी सूरत मांगे.
Yes. आ नहीं सकता लेकिन
ओके सो अमीनुल आई हैव टू रिमूव यू माय डियर बिकॉज़ योर कैमरा इज नॉट ऑन नाउ everybody smile please I can see some more with camera people are here
you have an option of hiding non video participants
okay
the zoom will do that automatically if they don't show their face
okay so smile please everyone thank you And Commander Vijay Kumar ji, this is the first occasion in DPMI where I have seen that my full Zoom was full, and that's why I was sharing my live Facebook live link so that the people those who are not getting here, they can go there and they can watch it. So yes. Congratulations, and it's all
Thank you so much.
The credit goes to you.
Very energetic, energetic students. The way they were answering is really felt thrilled. That so much knowledge is there with them.
And of course, I was so surprised to see immediately within no time 42 answers, 50 answers.
Yeah,
they were so quick. Okay, then thank you everyone, and inshallah, if Altaf sir, if you are sending them the award money. Right now,
yeah, only one left. Like I think we have shared only Shahnawaz Alam didn't share till now, and I don't know what is the problem from his end.
Like you send the award money. You send already award money to them.
Yeah. Maximum of them we share it too, but Mr. Shahnawaz Alam is only left. Like we don't have a detail.
Wow.
So nice. Yes. It's like Amitabh Bachchan in Kaun Banega Crore. Account में गया.
Yes, so nice of you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Altaf sir. Thank you, Farooq sir. Thank you, all the students. And I have shared with you one information about pitching opportunities. So please do pitch. Do have the ideas. अगर आप ideas नहीं रखेंगे, चाहे वो fail होते हो तो कोई बात नहीं है. Fail होइए, लेकिन आप कुछ ideas रखिए, कुछ pitch कीजिए, कुछ देखिए आपके ideas में कितना दम है. At least the experts are going to give you the advices, whether your idea is worth functioning or not worth functioning. What are the challenges of you in your ideas? Please keep on thinking, keep on working. Thank you very much, everyone. With this, we come to the end of today's program. See you, inshallah, very soon. Thank you, Vijay Kumar ji. Thank you, all the students. Thank you, Kainat ma'am. Thank you, Intihab sir. Thank you, all the faculty of DPMI, and thank you, all the winners and participants. Take care and bye-bye.